watching me live on MQR AICUG TV. Today I'm glad to have with me on a session Dr. Paul sir. Sir is the consultant gynecologist and endoscopic surgeon. Sir is the chairman for Paul's Hospital, director for Kochi Gynecological Society Endoscopic Training Center. Sir is also the board member of the International Society of Gynecology Endoscopy and elected member for the Society of Reproductive Surgeon ASRM. So welcome to the show, sir. So sir, based on your recent talk in ASUG Bhubaneswar, which was on the laparoscopic management of ureteric surgery, so we'll like to understand from you, during the gynecological surgery, how common are the ureteric injuries?
Uteric injuries are not very rare, and most of the injuries are contributed by gynecological surgeries. And in gynecological surgeries, probably less than 1 to 2% of incidents have been reported.
Okay. And sir, what can be the probable reasons for such kind of injuries during the gynecological surgeries?
We know that our gynecological organs, reproductive organs and ureter is in close association. And there is a high probability of getting injured during difficult gynecological surgery, especially laparoscopic surgeries.
Right, sir.
So, especially when there are the uterus is enlarged grossly, or there are multiple fibroids distorting the uterine size and touching the pelvic sidewall, or there are conditions, adhesions which causes the distorted anatomy. These are all the possible causes for or high risk cases for ureteric injury during gynecological surgical procedures.
Right, sir. So if you want to avoid or prevent such kind of ureteric surgeries during gynecological surgery, what advice you would like to give to the gynecologist so that we can reduce this kind of, even if it is a rare?
Every surgeon, gynecological surgeon, has to really identify the ureter. It can be done very easily during the visual examination itself. So always orient yourself, the position of the ureter, the important structures like infundibular pelvic, the ureter, and where it enters to the bladder. Most of this can be seen if you do a thorough evaluation of the pelvis in most of the cases. But in cases where there are a lot of adhesions, probably you have to do ureterolysis to clearly identify the ureter. So identifying such high-risk cases and visualizing the ureter directly or by ureterolysis. And very rarely people do a ureteric stenting before difficult surgeries, but it has not proven to be of much use to really prevent ureteric injury.
So sir, if by chance we come across such kind of ureteric injuries, so how to manage these ureteric injuries?
If you look at the real situation, only 1/3 of ureteric injuries are identified during the gynecological surgery itself. So this is the best time to identify any injury and then rectify. So the surgeon should try to identify any high-risk cases, and not only that, during surgery, if you have found it difficult to dissect those cases, you must do some checking like cystoscopy and looking at the ureteric urine jet. You can give some idea whether a transection or a major injury has occurred to the ureter.
Okay, sir. So, sir, what will be your key message to the gynecologist if you want to prevent ureteric injuries during gynecological surgeries? And if you come across, what should be the way to treat this?
I already mentioned that every surgeon, whenever you plan for a surgery, try to identify the high-risk cases I already mentioned. And also during surgery, you try to identify or you do a ureterolysis if necessary during difficult surgeries. And if in any doubt, you must do additional measures to identify by doing a cystoscopy. And if you identify a ureteric injury, probably you need the support of a urologist, but you also should be able to do this procedure under their supervision. And most of these surgeries can be done laparoscopically. And traditionally, we have been taught to do ureteric implantation, but nowadays, very few cases need to be done by implantation. Most of the cases can be done by laparoscopic rejoining or real anastomosis of the ureter.
Okay, so thank you so very much, sir, for such a wonderful discussion and providing the information to prevent the ureteric injuries during gynecological surgery. Thank you very much.